Hello and welcome to another outdoor tutorial on monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fehrmann, and in this video I'm going to explain some basics about the measurement of tree heights with laser devices. You see me standing here in a very open area. It is a windthrow area where very heavy storms in the last winter throw all these spruce trees. These even-aged plantations are not very stable. But this is also a nice position to explain laser devices because it's a very suitable spot where I can see a lot of trees. I brought two laser devices, one a little bit cheaper, a Nikon Forestry Pro, another one a little bit more expensive, a True Pulse laser from Laser Technology. The Nikon device can measure distances based on laser and inclination angles, while the True Pulse laser can measure distances, inclination angles and horizontal angles. So this is a three-axis sensor, and that's why it is much more expensive. Talking about lasers in general, what makes them very interesting is that we can measure huge distances. So in open areas like here, I can easily measure the height of hundreds of trees from one position. I don't need any reflector, and the laser can measure distances of up to 200 or 300 meters. So that makes it very interesting for open areas. However, if we come to very dense conditions in forest areas where we have dense understory, for example, laser has its limitations. When we are using a laser beam to measure distances, we can never be sure that we are really measuring the distance to our target or the distance to anything that is in between us and our target, which might be a couple of branches or dense understory. So in very dense forest, may be dangerous or critical to use a laser, but in open forest, it's very efficient. For the measurement of tree heights, such devices usually provide us two different measurement modes. One is the known three-point measurement that you already know from other devices, where we measure a horizontal distance and angle to the top and to the base of the stem. The second measurement mode is something that is specific to laser instruments, because we can use a two-point measurement approach where we measure the distance to the tree top and the inclination angle, and the distance to the base of the stem and its inclination angle. On the figure you see here, you can see that we can then calculate the height by multiplying the slope distance by the sine of the inclination angle. And this can be very helpful, and this can also be helpful in very dense forest conditions. Imagine you are working in a tropical forest where the highest trees are maybe 60 to 80 meters high, and you need huge distances to see the treetop. Maybe 100 meters or even more. In such cases where you have very limited visibility, the sine method can be very helpful to calculate the tree height. If you measure the distance to the tree top and the inclination angle, you can calculate a tree height in flat terrain, and this can be very useful. Okay, let's measure a tree height. I'm here using a Nikon Forestry Pro, and I'm going to measure the height of a spruce tree on the other side of this opening, which is quite far away. I'm using a three-point measurement mode, and that means my first measurement is the distance to the tree. And I can point to any position on the stem, since this is an upright standing tree. The second measurement is an angle to the top of the tree, and the third measurement an angle to the base of the stem. So let's measure the distance. And the distance here is 82 meters, so quite far away. Angle to the top. Angle to the base. And my total tree height is calculated as 28.8 meters for this spruce tree. Okay, let's summarize these laser devices. You can imagine that such laser devices can be very efficient and very fast. You can measure a lot of trees in very short time if you have free visibility. In case of the Nikon device, one small drawback is that it can only measure distances of more than 10 meters. So this is not very useful for sample plot assessments if you like to measure the distance of trees that are closer than 10 meters. This one, the TruePulse device from laser technology, can also measure shorter distances. In both cases, even if these devices are very nice and very handy, be sure to take a backup instrument in the field, since both of them need batteries, and imagine your batteries are empty and you're in the middle of field work, it's always a good idea to have a backup instrument at hand. Okay, so far about the basics of laser measurements, and see you in one of our next tutorials.